The VLOOKUP function allows you to look up information from a table of data. In this segment, you'll learn how to find and activate the function, and how to use the function in its two forms to find an exact match and an approximate match. The first aspect we're going to look at with the VLOOKUP function is where you find an approximate match. What you have here is some student numbers and results from a test, and what you'd like is to put the symbol that relates to that result. We have a symbol table here which indicates what scores generate what symbols. In order to do this using VLOOKUP, you do the following. Click on the cell where the answer needs to be put, activate the function wizard, and find the VLOOKUP function, which will be in lookup and reference. Because of the V, it's right at the bottom. Press OK. And now you have to fill in the criteria. The first one they ask for is the lookup value, and this is the value that Excel has been told to look up in the database. And as you'll see, it says whatever this value is, it needs to be the first column in the database you're going to use, which would be here. So in this case, we want to look up that value. The table array is the table containing the text numbers or values which need to be retrieved. In that case, it's here, and you have to highlight the entire section. So in this case, you'd highlight it like that. Now it's important to realize that because you might copy paste this formula, it's very useful to anchor this by making it absolute. So what you need to do is put the dollar signs in there. The next criteria is asking you, when it finds the number you're looking for, what column must it pull through? And in terms of numbering, this is considered column 1, this is 2, that would be 3, etc. In this case, we wanted to pull through number 2. And the last criteria is it asks you, how do you want me to look this up? Must I find it as an approximate match, or must I find an exact match? Now, because of the nature of this information, the results can be anything. It could be 75.3, it could be any number. So it's useful to put these numbers into bands and assign a symbol, and therefore it's an approximate. In that case, it indicates that you must either type true or omit it. We'll type true, and when you press OK, you'll see that the symbol is pulled through. And what Excel is doing is it's taking the 75%, looking here and saying no, the 75% is higher than that, going to the next one, looking, saying no, no, it's higher, and so it continues until it hits the number which represents the number being pulled, and then it pulls through the information that you requested. And now it's possible to copy and paste this so that it automatically pulls through all the relevant information. Now that you have sorted out the symbols relating to the results, you want to build a little query tool where, by typing in the student number, you will get the percentage and the symbol with the correct person. Now, because the student numbers are not in ascending order, and because they are unique, this is a situation where you might want an exact match. In order to use VLOOKUP in this situation, you click on that cell, activate the function wizard again, and you go through the process again. The lookup value is the number you wanted to look up. In this case, it's that cell there. The table array. The table is now this table here. And because you are eventually going to look up the symbol as well, you highlight the entire area. And again, I can't emphasize enough, I suggest you anchor it by making it absolute. The column index number, in this case you're looking for the percentages. That's the first column, so it's the second column again. Type in a 2. And now it comes to the range lookup. And as indicated earlier, if you put a true or you omit it, it's going to find an approximate match. So it will guess in which area this number sits and give you a number. We know that that needs to be exact. And so what we want to do is type in the word false. We click OK. And what you'll see is it looks up that number and finds the relevant percentage. So if we typed, for example, a 120, this will change to reflect that new number. And if we want to pull through the symbol as well, we just go through the exact same process. The lookup value again will be here. The table array is indicated. Anchor it. The column index number in this case, however, is it's actually the third column. So you type in your 3. The range lookup is false. And you press OK. And now both will be pulled through. So now whatever number, student number you request, the correct result and symbol will be pulled through. If for whatever reason you type in a number here that doesn't exist in the database, so for example let's put in A101, an error message will be generated, and that's basically Excel telling you that it cannot find an exact match. Although this could be a problem sometimes, it's often better to find out that you made a mistake here than to have a problem where it tries to guess the approximate number and you're never actually sure whether the correct information is being pulled through.